What's up, everyone? Good morning. It's your girl, Kara Corey here, and it's Saturday. We're going to do a little weekend vlog for you guys and just hit up a, what did I do? I did an upper body session over at Powerhouse. So you guys are going to see that footage somewhere in the video along with some commentary. And then Jason and I both brought our laptops over to Freedom of Espresso. It's a coffee shop here locally in Syracuse, which is really cool because they allow you to bring your dogs in, because I guess the owners really love dogs. So Bruce Wayne is here with us as well. We're just getting some work done, trying to kind of get the day started off on a good foot so that we're ahead of the game. And I don't know what else we have going on. It's a nice hot summer day in Syracuse, so hope to get outside if the man behind the camera is on board with that. Yeah, that's it for right now. Back at home, guys, about to eat some lunch. I'm super hungry. On Fridays, like right down the street, there's a little farm near us, which is really nice about like living in like a country kind of farm area. They all have like their little farmer stands up this time of year, and he grabs some fresh strawberries there. So I had some of those, I snacked on those. And then they also drive around like this fresh fish truck, which I believe is fish from Maine. Is it Maine? Yeah. So this fresh fish truck will like stroll through every Friday. So Jason went yesterday, grabbed us some fresh haddock and some shrimps. So that's what I'm gonna eat right now. Jason made it for me. I know y'all are shocked, but he makes me good food and I like to let him make me good food. Just tastes better. So I've got here 6 ounces of the fresh haddock and I seasoned it with my very dirty looking Spice Beast. This is the Big Buzz seasoning. I don't know what's all in here. It's like coffee rub type flavor. It's just really good on seafood. So I've got that. And then with it are just some frozen sweet peas that are all mashed up. And then I added to it some coconut spread for a little bit of fats. So that's just, I don't know, something about peas and haddock. It's just like a good combination. So that's what I'm going to have for lunch and see how I feel. What's up, guys? I am going to show you some of my workout from today. This was an upper body workout day, and I'm not showing you the entirety of my workout, just some bits and pieces from it. I actually don't do my own training right now. I work with Brian Devins from Upstate Empire Fitness. So he does all my training plans, and yeah, I just don't think it'd be fair for me to show you guys everything since he writes them specifically for me. But what I wanted to talk about instead of the actual workout footage itself was something that Jason said to me the other day that really kind of hit home with me. I feel like he's always giving me these little Easter eggs, these like wise bits of information. I don't know where he comes up with this stuff, but he always hits home with me and I like to share it with you guys. I had just mentioned to him the other day like how motivated I had been feeling and just overall inspired, and that, you know, part of that I feel like is due to the people I have been surrounding myself with, and, you know, oftentimes you're a product of the people you're most frequently around, right? In terms of your attitude and what you're doing in your life. And I was just telling him how motivated I have felt from being around certain individuals. And, you know, he said, "That's great, Kara." He said, "But don't forget to be motivated by yourself. You know, you can't rely on other people motivating you." And it's like, man, that's so true. And I know it too. It's so true. But I think it's such a good reminder. And it really did kind of make me think more about my own self and what I'm proud of and what I've done and what motivates me and inspires me to be better. And I wanted to share that message with you guys because I think it's really important, because a lot of us go to YouTube and Instagram to be motivated, especially with people who are into fitness and look great and are fit and healthy. But at the end of the day, you really have to be your own motivation, because that motivation from other people is only going to last so long. And even being internally motivated by our own self, it only goes so far. You really do have to put into place discipline and drive to follow through on any of your goals, whether they're workout related or career related or relationship related. You do have to kind of create a discipline there. But I just thought it was a nice reminder to focus on being motivated by you, and it made me want to just kind of share that, you know, I have been motivated by myself in terms of my fitness goals. I really think back to a period of time when all I was focused on was being skinny and being the smallest person in the room. And how far I've come, you guys, with that, because man, that's the last thing from my goal right now. It's about feeling fit and healthy and looking strong. And it feels damn good to be proud of myself. And when I think back at my journey, it motivates me and inspires me. And it's cool. It's good to be motivated by yourself. So I want you guys to think about that. If you take anything away from this video, think about what motivates you from your own self. And if you don't mind, comment that below. One positive thing about yourself that motivates you to do better, and share it with the community below. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video, and that's it. Good timing. I finished up with my lunch, sipping a little caffeine, a little cold brew here. Doorbell rang, and we got a big package in the mail. We had placed an order with Tiger Fitness because we've got some new stuff coming out we're gonna share with you from Pervitum. But then we also had to like restock, re-up on stuff that we go through, so.
So you should break the news to them.
Break the news, oh shit. I don't like this news, it makes me really sad. You guys know with Pervitum, we have the vegan protein and chocolate. You guys know I swear by that, I use it. Like
every night,
the time for my protein brownie bowls. Like I just always use them. Unfortunately, the vegan protein is being discontinued. Sucks, but there is another option available through Tiger Fitness that I'll recommend for you guys that I did get today to try out. It's called Planta. Vegan protein, great substitution from the Pervitum with tons of different flavors. So that's something you guys always ask me about with the Pervitum protein, if they were gonna ever come out with other flavors.
Thank you. I'm trying to hand it to you and you're like.
I thought you were doing your part for the video. Like,
Bruce, sit down.
You need to have a role in this too, okay? Do your part. Bruce is doing his part with his teddy bear.
Sit. It. Okay, get it. He wants me to really play with him, but I don't want to.
Okay, so we've got the Planta.
Planta.
We got it in the peanut butter cup flavor, so I'm probably gonna try this out as my Pervitum vegan brownie bowl substitute and see how it turns out. I'll let you guys know. Let's see, this is my first time actually even looking at Planta. It's a pea protein, organic rice protein in there, peanut flour, cacao, coconut, sugar. We've got a gum blend like your xanthan gums, make it thicker. Natural peanut butter cup flavor, sunflower lecithin, lohan gua.
Don't ask me to say it.
Says it's a fruit and sucralose. So all the other flavors, ooh, let me show you all the other flavors for those wondering.
The banana maple is amazing. I had that at Mark's house. Is it banana maple French toast?
Banana maple French toast.
It's seriously good.
Strawberry cupcake, mint, cocoa, sprinkle cupcake, blueberry scone. There's an unflavored option for you guys. That might be good. Cinnamon roll, chai spice. I feel like unflavored would be great for vegans who like are just trying to get in the protein but don't want something sweet.
Who doesn't want something sweet? Like, what are you going to do? It'd be good in like a smoothie.
You can add it into stuff.
Yeah, like, in a smoothie or something would be good. That would be perfect.
You could add it into like a vegan stew or something.
But at Mark's house, he made us a smoothie with blueberries and the maple banana French toast. I'm like, yeah. I don't think banana maple French toast protein would be good.
Yeah.
And the first thing I did was when I texted you, I'm like, oh my God, this
he
is amazing.
It. Yeah. Dang, I really want a peanut butter cup now.
And next on the list, a favorite of ours.
Ritual, which we're almost out of. Actually, that's what I put in my cold brew coffee. I did a little bit of almond milk, and then I added a half a scoop of Ritual, and it just makes it so sweet and creamy. It's basically your substitute for not only sweetener in your coffee, but cream. So if you're like myself, I like cream and Splenda, and I don't need either of those things when I add the Ritual. so delicious.
It is.
And those are both under the Ambrosia Collective.
And for the new stuff.
The new stuff. So per vitam,
again,
yes.
Here.
We the protein's going away. It's sad, but something that's been in the works for a long time is the hair, skin, and nails formula. I think we talked to Chad about it like a year ago. It must
be. We did. It's been
a
while.
At least a year ago. We've had some things on the radar for Pervitam. This stuff just takes a really long time, but it is now available on the Tiger Fitness website, so you guys can go there. It's an affordable option, you guys. A lot of hair, skin, and nails products are
overpriced
for what you're getting in them. I mean, really, this has got a lot of good stuff in it that's going to help support hair, skin, and nails. So for hair, skin, and nails, we have vitamin C in there, vitamin E, biotin, choline, calcium, zinc, copper, little sodium. Really nice about this, it's got OptiMSN in it, which is a hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is great for your skin. This is something I look for with my skincare regimen for things that I use, even in makeup. They're putting hyaluronic acid in a lot of makeup now for us ladies out there. Moisturizers, night creams, all that kind of stuff, really great for your skin. So it's basically got a ton of vitamins, minerals, essential amino acids that are just gonna support hair, skin, and nails, which is great. Like, I will take anything I can get for my hair because I do add bleach to my hair to get that, like, blondish color in it. So it's not so great for my hair. Be interested to see how this helps my hair, but as well as my skin. I haven't tried it yet, you guys, so this is my first time getting it. So I'm going to be starting on this, and I will be sure to let you guys know my results because you guys know I've had my struggles since being off birth control with, like, on and off hormonal acne. So I'm curious to see what results I get with this.
How much is that?
This is only $10.99.
$10.99.
Good lord, that's a good deal right there. So, ooh, okay, we got all hooked up on hair, skin, and nails.
Well, that's four. It's only 2 months worth.
That's true.
Because we both take it every day.
We're gonna take it too, yeah.
We got four of these.
Four regulators, which we need. We go through that real quick, so we both take that every day.
Which is a. You gotta remember the here.
This could be your first time here. I forget that you guys aren't all regulars.
It's like she's a noob to this whole YouTube thing.
If this is your first time watching this video, welcome. My name's Kara Corey. I'm a registered dietitian, and I am here to help you with all things fitness, fun, fashion. And my husband Jason's here sometimes too, as well as Bruce Wayne. But with Pervitam, we have a few different options for supplements, and Pervitam is more of a lifestyle brand, which is why it was kind of like the perfect collaboration for me personally, because as you guys know, I have the bodybuilding history, but that really isn't my like end-all, be-all passion. I'm just more like fitness and health for life, and that's what Pervitam kind of stands for. It's just like healthy living, longevity, quality of life. So we have things like Regulator, which is a complete probiotic. It's going to give you everything you need, because a lot of us don't get in all the probiotics we need through our diet. If you can, that's ideal and great, but having a probiotic supplement is just going to help with your overall gut health, which as we now know influences so many other things in our body, you know, our physical and mental health. So should have some type of probiotic in your regimen if you don't already. Jason and I both take that every day.
And you get your Acumen.
And then Acumen is also, actually, if you buy the hair, skin, and nails right now, you get Acumen for free. I don't know how long that's lasting for, though.
It's just
so.
July 4th.
Oh, okay. So
deal only. July 4th.
So that's an advanced turmeric complex. There is not black pepper in this. I know some people have asked me, but you could kind of pair this around a meal that you add some pepper to, and that's just going to enhance its bioavailability and absorption within your body. I take that every morning. We've also got Hemp Daily here. We just get one of those guys?
Just got one.
Hemp Daily. So I have a full video on this if you guys want to go watch it, talking more about the research behind having hemp or a CBD product in terms of a lot of the health benefits that it can provide, in particular
inflammation,
pain management, just management of anxiety and stress, things like that help you with sleep and relaxation.
Mm-hmm.
What else we got? We've got vitamin D3.
Actually, this is vegan.
This is vegan.
Yep. Most people don't realize that most vitamin D3 is not vegan. It's made with sheep's wool.
Sheep's
wool grease.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yeah, sheep's wool grease is what they're mostly made of. This is not. That's completely vegan.
Fun little fact for you.
That's why it's called Vega. Vega.
Vega. Ether. I get that. I like it.
You got nutrient driver. Oh, thank God. How long have we been out of these for?
Greens. Like 2 weeks, maybe?
Yeah, we've been
like ever since I got back from Houston, we were out. And I'm like, no, I need these. I feel like this is what helps prevent me from getting sick. I bring these with, well, not the whole tub, but I bring it with me when I travel.
We get so many, not because we're greedy, but because we both take them daily. So
it's 30 servings.
So four only last 2 months. So yeah. We don't want to be like, hey, send us, you know, right. Every single month.
We actually use the stuff we promote, so. Yeah.
Love these.
Ooh, the wafers. Have you guys tried these? I like the vanilla the best, honestly, because I feel like they're sweeter than the chocolate.
They are, which is crazy. Mm-hmm. I thought I'd like the chocolate more. Don't get me wrong. I love me my chocolate.
I do too.
I'm going to have one
but
of those.
But the texture of a wafer. Mm. There's nothing like the texture of a wafer.
These guys. Oh.
Ooh, did you pick the flavors? Or
I
did
picked
you...
the flavors.
Mm, butterscotch. Is butterscotch your favorite?
This is my favorite, I think.
The white chocolate cranberry?
And then this is a close second.
They're so good.
If you haven't tried Outright Bars.
So creamy.
They'll be in gas. They're in gas stations now. Just, you know, it's a slow rollout.
That's really cool.
Or you can order them on Tiger Fitness.
Right.
And last but not least, my favorite protein. The Red Velvet.
Red Velvet.
Almost out. I have like five scoops left.
That's it?
That's it.
I mean, that's it of the what you have left of this?
Yeah, let me make maybe 10 scoops max. I use at least a scoop a day, sometimes two.
Believe it or not, this is actually a small order from Tiger Fitness for us.
It is.
I'd say not a cheap order, but a smaller, smaller order. But we're all stocked up now. And I'm going to start my hair, skin, and nails today.
Me too, actually.
And just one thing, I don't know if it says it on the label or not. It says take four capsules at once. I find for me personally, just because it's a mega dose of vitamins, that's typically what's in these types of products. I can't take it on an empty stomach. I don't know about this one in particular, but I
ate recently, so it'll be good.
I personally like to take it with a meal for absorption. It just doesn't make you as nauseous.
And actually, well, you mentioned that. Be careful when you take any product, because this, for example, has 133% of your daily value of vitamin C. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to go buy another vitamin C.
Yes.
And start taking
Take a look at, because this does have so many other vitamins and minerals in it, take a look at what else you're taking.
She has a video on vitamin D toxicity.
Yeah.
Probably like three, this is, those are yours, these are mine.
I know.
3 years ago, maybe, she got vitamin D toxicity.
I think it was like 5 years ago. It's been a long time since
I've had
blood
work.
So
if you want to know about vitamin toxicity, I highly suggest you look up that video. Just type in Karakori vitamin toxicity. It'll come up.
I am getting some updated blood work done next month. It took me a while to find a new doctor who's kind of on the same page as me, but we're going to do, he basically told me, bring a list of whatever you want tested, like hormonally. Don't be drinking all my coffee.
It's a sip.
No, I know your sips. Your sips are gulps.
They're gulps.
Man gulps.
Bruce Wayne is wrapped around Kara's legs.
Yes, I like it. It's warm and cozy. But I am getting updated blood work next month. And I don't know if I've mentioned that here, but I'm going to share that with you guys because I just find it really interesting to better understand what's going on in your body internally, like before you make any dietary changes or just lifestyle changes. It's good to know kind of those laboratory values, although it may only be a snapshot, right? So you kind of have to understand how each blood level is influenced. But really good information. So I highly encourage you, if you haven't done that in a while, like myself, I've been really bad about it. I'm trying to be better about staying on top of that stuff. So I'll have a whole video on that and share with you all my lab values. I think that'd be cool. Take two at a time because I'm a puss.
I take four. He's looking at me so sad.
Because you're not playing with him.
How much milk do you think I should use? Just like 2 ounces because there's frozen blueberries in there?
Are you trying to make it drinkable?
Yeah. Drinkable. But thick still, kind of.
Yeah, you probably don't need much.
I overdid it last time.
I'm going with 2 ounces. Which you can't take away.
Right.
Where'd we put it? Oh, here it is. What? Scoops on the top.
What's that?
Scoops on the top.
Sweet. That never happens.
No, it does not. You want to try this for the first time on camera?
Sure.
I don't know if I blended it. It might need a little more blending, but we're going with it.
I'm mixing it. Hang on a second.
They let you look sketchy, like you're doing something to it. Stop being all weird.
I just put mouthwash in.
And lipstick, so you ruined my straw.
Wow.
How is it?
Tastes like a peanut butter cup.
Well, it's called peanut butter cup.
I know, but there's like, doesn't look like it's gonna taste like a peanut butter cup.
Is it? So it's good?
Delicious.
That's awesome.
I like the consistency of it.
Yeah. So, what did you say about Fitburn or Ambrosia Planta? So far, so good?
Yeah, I really enjoy that flavor.
Gonna try the brownie bowl tonight?
I'm definitely gonna try the brownie bowl with it so I can let you guys know how it compares if, you know, because the protein's a little bit different.
Well, that's good.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Really good. Ooh, let's break open the greens. Let's get wild in here. Getting wild for us is like drinking caffeine late in the day and staying up past 10 p.m.
Yep.
And going somewhere like past 7 p.m. If yes. We're out of the house past 7 p.m., we're
it's
like
a crazy night.
We're like we're fucking the shit. Like everyone wants to be like us.
Mm-hmm.
We're out at Target.
Yep.
Doing
sometimes
our
a movie.
Sometimes maybe and dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Bed Bath and Beyond. I don't know if we're gonna have time though. Depends if we have time.
Name that movie.
Name that movie.
Mm.
Why you got the sink going, boo?
I was cleaning this dish off.
I'm bringing a scooper of that with me.
It does taste like a peanut butter cup. I guess if you don't like peanut butter cups, meaning you're not American, then don't get it. But if you like peanut butter cups, I'd give it a try.
If you don't like peanut butter cups, I'm going to need you to unsubscribe. Do I want to wear sneakers or flip-flops? I'm going to bring a little coat because the mall's probably going to be cold. I'm so hungry. Shopping makes me hungry.
So does not eating.
Mm-hmm. Only ate the one meal today, you guys. I'm starving. It's almost 6 o'clock. Jay and I had went to the mall. Just wanted to see if there's any 4th of July sales. And I think I did pretty good. I kept it under control, but I did get one pair of sneakers that I had actually been eyeing for a while. I looked at these probably the beginning of May. And they were on sale for $120. They're like $30 off, I guess. But they are the Nike Air, I think they're the Air 270s, Air Max 270s. And I was just really drawn to the neon bright color. I had actually wanted a pair like this in the fall and I couldn't find anything I liked. You remember that, Jay, when we were going to Florida? I was looking for a pair of neon sneakers. So something about these, I was just drawn to them. I already wore them through the mall. They're super comfortable. So I love them. I'm excited to call them mine. I'm just eating an outright wafer right now because I had actually brought one to eat on the car ride home, but it was all melted and I didn't want it melted because I'm a picky little bitch. So I'm just eating a cold one that we had at home while I figure out what for realsies I'm gonna eat for dinner. Mmm, so good. The macros on these are titties too.
They are, they're super good.
Mm-hmm.
Like
15 protein, 13 carbs, 6 fat, 9 mm-hmm. fat? 1 to 2?
9 fat.
9 fat?
But yeah, I'm gonna eat some real food. I just kind of needed, like, you know how you need, like, you need a snack. You need to pregame it before you go into dinner, or else.
You're screwed.
Yeah. I had to have something, so this is hitting the spot. Does anybody else work out at 7 a.m. and just stay in their workout clothes, including their sports bra, all day? I don't know if that's laziness or just living, but it feels good, you guys. I feel good staying like this all day. Scumming it up like a schlob kebab.
I already ate half my ice cream that I had set the camera. If you're wondering why my bowl is so sad.
I'm so excited for my dinner. God, I love the weekends. It's just so much easier to eat healthy. I've said this before, but maybe you're new here. It's so much easier to eat healthy on the weekends, like, because I just love being able to put things together in my kitchen. I hate having to plan ahead. I'm sure that's like a first world problem, but you know, when you have to be at work for 10 hours, it's like, I don't know what I'm gonna wanna eat all day. I digress, I've got a pretty tasty meal right here. Apparently it's seafood Saturday, because we've got here some shrimps that Jason also grabbed at the fish truck yesterday. So I've got 5 ounces of shrimps seasoned up that we cooked in the air fryer for just like not even 5 minutes. I've got a serving of sweet potato fries. These I got, like, they're basically just plain yams already sliced up like a fry that I got from Wegmans. Those are seasoned up. Cook those all in a little avocado oil. So I'm gonna have that. And then I've got this tasty looking salad with it. I've got organic mixed greens that just look so good from Wegmans, topped with some pomegranate seeds, some pistachio nut meats. Every time it gets me.
Gets me too.
Nut meats. Who wants merch that says nut meats on it? All right, anyways.
You should also let them know that the shrimp are pre-cooked. Because you don't want people cooking
don't
shrimp
worry.
For 5 minutes in the air fryer and getting sick.
These are pre-cooked shrimps. All you had to do was like either run them underwater or thaw them in the fridge, which we did, and then I just wanted to cook them up. And the salad, nut meats, bell pepper, pomegranate seeds. And then for dressing, I've just used this Newman's Own light balsamic, put a tablespoon of that on there, and look how tasty this dinner is. I feel pretty good about it. I'm excited and starving. So we're gonna eat that, get a glass of water, because I am parched.
You going bike ride?
And then, yeah, if you guys have been following along the weekend vlogs, Jay and I tend to hit up our bikes for a bike ride and enjoy the weather. So that should be fun. Get a little cardio in. We like to catch up, get some chatting done. And it's nice because it sounds silly, but I like it because we can't really be on our cell phones when we're riding our bikes. Although we saw a guy on his bike today.
Texting.
And I was just like, dude, are you serious? On a super busy road. Like, what are you doing? We don't do that. Phones are put away. We're truly just like talking about whatever we want to shoot the shit about, enjoying each other's company, enjoying the outdoors. And it's one of my favorite things, Jay.
Mine too.
I love it.
Mine too.
It's fun. It brings me back to summer of 99. Were you guys alive then or nah? When Jay and I first started dating and, you know, we didn't have cell phones, and we used to just take late night summer walks and get blueberry muffins at midnight.
True story, it was 1999.
It actually was 1999, you guys, so we were babies. But gonna eat my food because it looks frickin' titties.
Why don't you show them up close?
I'm gonna show them up close. The up close shot. And if you're wondering why I'm straddling, if you can tell, do you see the legs between? Yep, Connie Corso there. My luxurious paper plate.
Try the shrimp. Who cares about that? Try the shrimp.
I love a sweet potato fries, though.
Hold one up in the camera.
Oh, here's my shrimp. Oh, there it is. I forgot with this camera, I don't have to do that.
Yeah, that's good.
Mmm.
Right?
Mmm.
Air fried shrimp.
Dog looks pissed right now. He's like, Mom, feed me.
Yeah, buy them first.
Mmm.
Told ya.
You guys, like, get on board with seafood, okay? expand your horizons and eat some fish.
Fish trucker? Just put out an air fryer.
Fish trucker?
Sorry, Fit Trucker.
Fish trucker! Fit trucker, you gotta change your handle to the fish trucker. What? No one's gonna think that's funny except for us. And Fit Trucker.
In Fish Trucker. You gotta air fry that shit.
Mmm.
He put an air fryer video.
Did he?
Uh-huh. As I talk with my mouth full.
Mmm. Shrimps are tasty.
They're so good.
Mm-hmm. I mean,
let's eat your eye.
I really like them slathered in like a butter garlic dipping sauce, but
no, I hate that shit. It ruins your food. You're literally
good for you. I like it. Slather it in butter.
It ruins the taste of the shrimp.
Mmm. Burnt sweet potato fries. Mmm. It's so good.
Sweet potato fries or shrimp?
All of it. All right. My ass is going to sit down and enjoy this. I was wrong.
Are you getting sexual with the shrimp?
I don't know. I don't know what's happening. I'm getting weird. I feel drunk and I'm not drunk. I'm just really excited about food.
And bike rides?
And bike rides.
Actually, Stranger Things is the reason we got bikes.
And Saturdays. I love Saturdays.
Me too.
Yep.
Season one is like, oh, they're riding bikes. That looks fun.
I know. That was how many years ago? 3 years ago we got them?
Huh?
Best investment. Actually, we bought Walmart bikes first. And we were like, no.
I warned you.
No, we can't do the Walmart bikes. You get what you pay for. So we went all into a bike shop in Syracuse and got good bikes.
$20,000. They're like $500 each.
Mm-hmm. But it's been worth that.
Sorry, the mic's over there if you can't hear me. It's actually right here.
I need
ready?
A little. I need
ready
a little...
for the mic? Open your mouth.
No. That's wrong. Stop it.
Ew. Just the tip. Just take the tip.
What's up, guys? Today is now Sunday, and it's late. It's dinner time, and I've just failed to pick up the camera today, although Jason typically sets it up on the tripod, but I failed to kind of vlog much today, and I was toying with sharing this or not because I do try to keep the channel positive energy and uplifting and helpful and just more focused on helping you guys than making it all about me, if that makes sense. But I don't know, I was thinking about just talking about this, making it sound like a big deal. It's not. But today's just been like a really bad body image day for me, and I feel shallow even mentioning that. But I've just felt like very low energy today and just like bad body image day. Like, we all have them, right? Like, even I'm sure even someone I would look at that I just think has the most perfect physique ever, I'm sure has a bad body image day, because oftentimes it's more about a feeling than anything, than necessarily looking in the mirror and going, oh, I've gained 10 pounds. Like, it's just a feeling for the most part. But yeah, I've just been kind of like struggling with it a bit today, which kind of makes me not as, it makes it harder for me to like hop on the camera and be peppy and positive and uplifting and give you guys like great tips when I'm over here like struggling and kind of like stuck in my own head a bit. So I just wanted to share that and just kind of talk through like what I do when I am struggling with it. I am about to eat dinner right now, so that's one of the things I want to mention. Like, I feel like some people, when they have a bad body image day, like their initial like reaction is to like restrict their diet or reel things in. And I've actually done the opposite today, which maybe is weird. I did a leg workout this morning and I just felt ravenous when I got home. Like I said, I was low energy and I just really felt like I just needed to listen to my body and eat like a really good meal. So I did. I ate like nearly 1,000 calories in a sitting. I just had like a really big meal. I basically ate two meals at once just to give myself more energy. But yeah, on a bad, when you're struggling through it, don't, there's no need to restrict. Nothing good comes from restricting if you're struggling with those feelings. You're almost in a way kind of feeding that negativity in your mind by doing that, if that makes sense. So for me, it was more about doing what I needed to do to feel more energetic today, to feel more positive and kind of get out of my own head of just being focused on what I felt my body looked like. Because really, you know, when you think about it at the end of the day, there's so many other important things, which is why I feel stupid talking about this. But I am, because I know so many people struggle with it, and people I work with struggle with it and tell me when they have bad body image days or weeks or months sometimes. So we all go through it, and I want you guys to know I go through it too. And try to give you some of my tips. So one of the things I do is not like feed into it and try not to basically sit there in those negative thoughts too long, because nothing good comes of them. So for me, instead of feeling like, ew, you don't look good, you look fat, or whatever those negative statements might be in your mind, I try to bring myself back to, okay, Kara, let's think with a realistic mind here. Are you healthy? Are you fit? Like, are you making good choices? And I like to think about, and I talked about this a little bit early in the commentary on the fitness video, but I like to think back to my journey and just how far I've come. And you guys, I really have come so far. I really, really have. Like, I never had an eating disorder, but I did struggle with disordered thoughts, clearly. Like, I did. Like, I was just so hyper-focused on being skinny and the need to be skinny and thin and small that it did consume me. It really, really did. So I think now, like, when I have days like this, I think about how far I've come and that I've gained so much muscle. Like, when I look back at photos of how thin I was, I don't look at that and go, ooh, I wish I still looked like that. Not that there was anything wrong with that body, but I look at it and I go, man, I looked frail and I looked a little weak. And I looked a little hungry, you know, and I feel like I can look in the mirror now, and even though I might be like, oh, I look bloated and my stomach's like a little bulk, I look in the mirror and I say, I look strong. Like, I look like I've gained some shoulder mass, and I look like I have a strong back, and I look like I'm fit and healthy, you know, and that helps me to kind of change my perspective and shift that focus. So that's another thing, is just not sitting in those negative thoughts too long, not letting them consume you, and don't feed them. I mean, feed your belly, but don't feed the negative thoughts. Try to do something to get your mind off it. You know, for me, I like going for walks, especially with my dog. Like, for me, and maybe for you, it's your fur fam, maybe it's your children, but my dog just takes all my cares away because I just love him so much, and he always puts a smile on my face. So if I'm ever going through anything, whether it's body image issues or a bad day at work or something bad happens, like, the dude knows how to put a smile on my face by just wiggling his tail and looking at me with his big dopey eyes. So, you know, do something that kind of reminds you of being more carefree and things that really just make you feel good and to care less about the stupid shit like your body. But like, for me, I'm going to go take him for a walk. It's sunny out. It's beautiful out. I'm just going to clear my mind, get some sunshine. That tends to always make me feel better as well. And that also helps me kind of shift my thoughts too. Just being out in the sunshine, in the world, in nature, it just does something for me where it clears my mind. It's very therapeutic for me. So it might be something different for you guys. Maybe it's taking a relaxing bath. Maybe it's playing your favorite song. Maybe it's reading a good book or playing a video game and just getting lost in it. And before you know it, you'll forget the stupid shit. Like, if you feel bloated or if you feel like your leggings are a little tighter than they were last week, you'll forget about it and remember that there's bigger things to focus on in this world. And I like to bring it back to, am I being a good person? You know, I don't really care to be remembered. Like, when I leave this world, I don't care to be remembered as the girl who maintained the fittest best physique for the longest. Like, I don't care about that. I want to be remembered as a girl who was kind to anyone. Someone that went out of her way to be helpful for people, who went out of her way to educate people and to lend a helping hand, even though no one asked or no one thanked her for it. You know, like, I want to be someone that is just known to be genuinely kind and uplifting. And so when I have bad days like this, I try to think about that. Like, what's really more important to me at the end of the day, you know? And that sometimes helps. And the other thing that helps too is just thinking about how much bad shit goes on in this world, you guys, like, and how blessed I am. Like, sometimes I'm astonished at, I hate even saying it, but being the age I am and really I haven't had a rough life. I'm going to be honest. Like, I haven't had a rough life. I had a really great childhood. I had a really great upbringing. I can pay my bills, you guys. Like, I have a job. I have a roof over my head. I have a man that loves me more than life itself. Like, a family who's just beyond incredible. So there's so many things I have to be grateful for. It feels gross to waste a day or even an hour sitting here going, meh, poor me, I don't feel good about my body today. But, you know, first world problems. And the reality is, you know, we feel these things, and it's not to say they're not valid. You feel them even if you are the most blessed person in the world. It doesn't mean you can't have a bad day. It doesn't mean you're not going to have a down day. But find coping mechanisms that are healthy coping mechanisms that get you out of that funk and that mindset. So hopefully some of those tips were helpful for you guys. And like I said, I know I didn't have a lot going on today. Today was just kind of like a chill day at home for Jason and I, so not really a lot to film for you guys. I know you guys have been loving the weekend vlogs with the Corys, and if you have, let me know if you want more of these. I feel like Jason and I do the same stuff like every weekend. We're pretty routine people, if you haven't caught on by now. We like doing a lot of the same things, and we're very content doing so. I think we have a lot of fun though here in the Corey household. So if you guys do still want to see more of these vlogs and more of Jason in them too, let me know. He's just really hungry eating his ice cream right now. But I also wanted to mention, I've gotten tagged in a bunch of you guys who shopped the Buff Bunny collection launch in June and used my code and took the time to screenshot and show me what you bought. And I appreciate you all so, so much. It really does mean the world to me that I know there is a lot of Buff Bunny collection affiliates. So you guys taking the time to use my code, which is code Kara, by the way, or shopping through my link really means the world to me and helps me out a lot. So if you guys did shop it and you're on Instagram, tag me in it, because I want to see how you guys are liking your stuff. A few people have done that already, and so far everyone is loving everything they got. Everyone is so impressed with the quality, as am I. I'm wearing the energy fabric and the capris and the sports bra, the spicy sports bra here, and the energy, the Live capris. She's got lots of stuff still available, so if you guys were wanting to shop it but you were waiting till you got that paycheck or something, go check it out, see if there's anything there you like. And there's also still stuff available from the previous launch, so she is able to kind of store a lot more right now. Stuff doesn't sell out as quick, which is nice. So anyways, I just want to thank you guys again for your support, and everything with the Buff Bunny collection launch means a lot. Yeah, I think that's going to be it for the weekend vlog. It's a holiday week, 4th of July. I'm going to spend time with family this week. My sister and I, we're going to do a 10-mile race, but something funny I'll ramble to you about for a minute. I think I had mentioned I was going to do the 10-mile race with my sister, and I went for a run the other week, and I just wasn't feeling, like, I loved my run, but the day after I felt like, God damn, my body just felt like it hurt like it shouldn't from a short run. And it made me concerned with doing a 10-mile run when I'm really not properly trained for it anymore. And really, was it going to be worth it? You know, in my 20s, I didn't think that way. I was like, I got this. I'm going to do it. And who cares? But as we age, you should start to care how it does impact you. And I have to be honest with myself. Could I run 10 miles if I wanted to? I know I can. I have the mental discipline and I do have the physical capability. But is it worth it to me? It's not so much. Not so much. And I said to my sister that. And she was like, yeah, I'm kind of also thinking the same thing. So, you know what? Cheers for us to listening to our bodies and not feeling like we have to do something. What we are going to do is go have like a little, we're going to go do a sister run anyways with no pressure of how far we run or how fast. And we're just going to have a fun time. And then we're going to drive up north and visit my family. So I don't believe I'm going to vlog because I don't really know that you guys care to see family vlogs. Plus, my parents, I don't think personally want to be on the vlog, so it makes it a little hard for filming, but if you guys want to see something and have ideas, let me know. Be sure to comment below what more you'd like to see from us, and I hope you guys have a happy and healthy, fun 4th of July. Please, if your dogs are scared of fireworks, don't leave them alone. Don't leave them outside. I feel like I always hear horror stories of people losing their dogs on 4th of July because of the fireworks, so I don't know. Take any of that advice you want. I'm gonna eat this watermelon because watermelon is the tits. It's just so refreshing, you know? We buy the mini watermelons and they're so good. They last a while too in the fridge, which is nice. And I'm not really good at talking and eating at the same time. So I apologize, but I'm going to eat my dinner. I've got a salad here, some watermelon, and I think this is going to wrap up the vlog. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, I just want to say I appreciate you all so, so much. You have no idea. If anything, thank you for letting me ramble on about my own stupid shit in this video. And I apologize if it wasn't as positive and upbeat. I promise you, I won't continue down this path, but I just wanted to be real with you guys because I try to be open and transparent, but also have the balance of keeping this a positive, uplifting community. So thank you guys again. I love you so much, and I'll see you in the next one.